It's the moment of truth. In all these videos about setting up Workspace ONE, syncing directories, adding apps, and configuring single sign-on, we've been working towards something. The goal is to log in from a device and then just watch the automatic processes of enrollment, app installation, and single sign-on. Well, I've got an iPhone to try. Let's do it. Fingers crossed. In most cases, the way users enroll their devices is just by entering their email address and password and then starting the Intelligent Hub app for the first time. That method is called email auto-discovery, and it is described in another video. If that's not configured, users will also need to know the org group ID and server name. To find the group ID, select the organization in the Workspace ONE UEM console, and then click Groups and Settings, Groups, Organization Groups, Details. And here's the group ID in the group ID field. For server name, users need to know the name of the Workspace ONE UEM server, even though they will be using Workspace ONE Access to authenticate. That is, even though we've set the source of authentication for Intelligent Hub to Workspace ONE Access, users still need the Workspace ONE UEM server name when they enroll, not the Workspace ONE Access server. We're in the Workspace ONE UEM console here, and so here is the server name for my instance of Workspace ONE UEM. Another enrollment setting I want to mention is registered mode. In this exercise, we're doing full mobile device management, but we could instead scroll up and click the Management tab and configured registered mode so users could log in to some Workspace ONE apps without requiring full MDM. We'll click Override and then enable the platforms we want. I could enable just some groups or all devices in the org group, and then the device is registered but not fully managed. If the user wants to access an app that requires full MDM enrollment, they get prompted to install the management profile. For this exercise, we're not doing registered mode. Okay, now we'll enroll an iOS device. In the App Store on my phone, I search for the Workspace ONE Intelligent Hub app, download, and open it. Here's where to enter the Workspace ONE UEM server name. But see that QR code thing? You could do that if you set it up, as described in the product documentation. Tap Next. Here's where to enter that org group ID. Tap Next. In the list, select the domain for the user. Tap Next. Now the username and password. Done. And sign in. Now, occasionally when enrolling, I've gotten a second login box. Not all the time. If you see something like this, the thing is you need to enter the domain name as part of the username, since there's no domain list. Enter the domain name without the .com, / and username and password, and click Submit. On the Privacy Message, tap Continue. Next, set up the profile. Creating profiles was covered in a couple of earlier videos. Tap Download Profile. Tap Allow for the download. Close the confirmation. The download is finished, so tap the blue box. Tap Install Profile. Scroll down and tap Open the Settings app. Tap Profile Downloaded. Then enter the passcode you use for your phone. Tap Install. The signing certificate for my lab expired, so that's why it's unverified. In the warning box, tap Install again. Tap Trust. Tap Done in the Profile Installed box. Now tap Workspace Services and tap More Details. Here, tap Kerberos to look at the single sign-on profile and see the apps for single sign-on. The SCEP setting also has to do with SSO. Oh, I'm getting prompted to install Salesforce. Tap Install. Setting up the Salesforce app for automatic installation was shown in an earlier video. Now it wants my authorization to install the app. Okay, now my profile is all set up. Take me to the hub. It wants me to create a passcode. Tap Next. And again with the passcode, tap Confirm. I'm going to skip this intro. And privacy again. Tap I understand. Data sharing. Scroll down and tap I agree. And here we are on the Favorites tab. Tap Apps, and you see all the categories. Tap All Apps. I have two Salesforce apps. One is the web app I configured, as shown in another video, and the other is the native app I deployed in Workspace ONE UEM. Both should use single sign-on. Let's try the web app first. Tap Open. Okay, that worked. But the website is not too easy to see on my iPhone. Let me go to my home screen and tap the app. I accept the EULA, and although it looks like it's prompting for credentials, if I scroll down, I see a section that says, or log in using WS1 Acme, which is my company's instance. That's how I configured the login page to look. If I tap my instance name, I see the Workspace ONE single sign-on process at work. Tap Allow to allow access. Tap something in the notification dialog, and I'm in. The single sign-on worked. I was not prompted again for credentials. Now I just want to show you what it looks like to an administrator after the device is enrolled. We're back in the Workspace ONE UEM console on the Devices dashboard. This is showing the iOS device I just enrolled and a Windows device that I also enrolled. Click List View to see the list of devices. Green means connected, red means disconnected. Click the iOS device name to go to the Details page, Summary tab, and drill down on a whole bunch of information. The Compliance tab shows that the device was checked for a passcode. The Profiles tab shows the passcode and the SSO profiles. The Apps tab shows the apps that are installed and managed. Updates shows OS updates found on the device. There's user account info and more. There's a lot.
For more Workspace ONE technical resources, be sure to visit techzone.omnissa.com.